Hey guys, if you are looking the way to begin your development, web development journey, you can just watch this video. This video is for authority beginner. So let us dive in. So here I have my VS Code opened. So let us create our index.html. So, the way of creating HTML, you just need to add extension of .html. So, here, the way of adding tag, you just put inside angle bracket. So, and the best way, the best use of VS Code, once you cross the tag, it also cross it, or once you cross the first part of tag. So, let us say welcome to HTML fundamental. So if I save in the way of run it or display it, you can just go to the directory and open with browser. So in my case I choose Google Chrome. So here you see, so this is the first way. So the way of adding comment to your code is to open angle bracket and the exclamation and two hyphen, so it will close automatically. So let's say this is comment, sorry, it's a double M. So you see it cannot show to the browser, but if you see the page source by right click to the browser and go down to the view page source, you see the comment is down here. So let us now go to the basic structure of HTML or basic layout. So let us comment this one. The shortcut for commenting is to just select and press Ctrl forward slash. You can open angle and type HTML. So here for HTML5 I need to specify my doc type before I open the cross HTML tags, HTML. So let us delete this one since it is already crossed. And here after we add our head tag, sorry, I spell it wrong, head. Layer title as my web site. So yeah, down here I think it's enough in the head. And here we can go to the body, which is the body of our website. So yeah, I can add, for example, head one, welcome to my website. So here you can also add P, which is stand for paragraph, and you can say my first website. So if I save and refresh the browser, see how it comes. So now let us go on, create a new file and call it meta.html. So here we are going to see some useful meta tags and seeing something about search optimization engine, or search engine optimization. So here, the best way of using HTML, so I'm not going to type the old tags. So if I press exclamation and hit tab or enter, so it will generate. So let us press Alt Z to wrap the content to fit to the container or to the text editor or to the VS Code. So here the first one is doc type. I said before it's for just to say the browser that this is HTML5. So yeah, it's HTML open and close tag with attribute of rank. So this is an attribute, so which is English. It's a language which is said to be English. And there are the tag of head, which it's where we put all our meta tags. So here it's our meta tag first, which is setting character to standard UTF-8. So and here we have another with name of viewport, which will help us to detect the size of device, if it is mobile or computer or tablet. So here we can add another related to search engine optimization. So here we can. So another way of typing tags with this VS Code, you simply type the name and hit enter or tab, and it will automatically open and close it. So yeah, name, let us say description. So this description is very good when we wanted the search engine to detect our website. So here content and say about, yeah there is website description. So every time they type in search engine the sentence or word related to this in description, so it will detect your website. So another one related to that, so let us add another meta with name of keyword. So in there we can add content, which is here you can put a keyword or anything related to your website. For example, services, you can list them. For example, if it is a web development company, can say web design, web development. And for example, SEO, search engine optimization. So you can list as much as you can, but if it is related to your content and end time, a user type to the search engine, one related to yours, it will be listed. So here also title is good for search engine to detect your site. So yeah, let us say my website. So the title and here description, it's very good. So here we can now proceed with headings. So let us add comment. So another way of adding comment is to press control forward slash. There, let us add our comment of headings. So in HTML there are 6 different headings. So heading 1. So let us add the heading head 1 and the content of heading 1. And let us duplicate by press Alt Shift arrow down. So 5, 6, So let us select this one and tag and press Ctrl D 2 times to select the next two. Yeah, the two. It's a free. Four. Five. Six. Let me save and open another way of just saving, and it will automatically load the browser. It's using live server extension. So yeah, you type live server if you are online, offline, so you can see nothing, but I have already installed it. So yeah, you can press here, go live, or just here, and open, and right click here in my file, and open with live server. So yeah, it is opened. So now I can progress with paragraph. Paragraph, you simply type p inside the angle tags and or angle bracket, and to close the tag you just need to add forward slash. So this is my paragraph. So you see paragraph, it's kinda small and it doesn't look bold as the headings. So here another good things about VS Code, it has built-in element which is help us to type faster and also contain dummy text. So if I add another paragraph and say lorem 25, so it will add this dummy text. So it is good for when you are designing and you are not yet putting the content and you just want to add placeholder, you can just use this dummy text. So yeah, if I save, you see it appear in the browser. So this comment. So there is another semantics like bold, so which you can just simply type B. So if I type B, so this is for bold. If I cross it right here, if I save, you see it become to the bold. So, and there is I for italic. Control F, Control V. So you see, it is changed to italic. So yeah, you can also, instead of using italic, you can use HTML5 EM4, which is stand for emphasize, and it will be the same. There is another code, del, which is used to strike through. So you see, it is strike through the word. So I can't recommend using this, but the best you can just write your text and do this in CSS. So yeah, this tag inside there is what we call inline tag, so it doesn't need to break, but paragraph and heading, as you see, it broke element tags, since once you add another, it break itself. So for example, a span also, it's online. So if I add another tag here, span, and I say online element, so it is going to ignore that break, because this is inline element. So while these headings are block element, whenever you add another, it just put to the next line. So you have to add block, just simply need to add br, which is block or black. So it will black the rest to the next line. So here I can proceed with link. Let us create another text and call it links.html. So here in links, let us generate a bare plate by pressing exclamation and hit tab. So you need to press Alt Z to wrap the content to the width of container. So here let us on the links and images. So let us add the heading one of links and images. So let us begin with links. Let us add the comment of links. So the way of adding links to your web page is just to using a tag. So here I type a, and once I hit enter, to just add this tag in each leaf. Let us say, for example, meta. So this will go to meta.html. So let us add meta. So and if I save, so I think this is not opened yet. So let us open with live server. You see the meta. So it is direct to that. Make it more meaningful. Go to meta. So yeah, once I create to it, put me there. And if you want to keep this page opened, and you want to go to the next one, that's duplicate by press Alt Shift arrow down. Yeah, we need to add attribute of target with blank. Sorry, it's blank. So, yeah, if I save, let us say open new tab. All windows. So if I press here, so you see it will keep this open. Let us close the other ones. So if I open, it will keep this one open and open the new next to it. So here you can also link. So I think I forget to close. So yeah, you can also link to the external resources. For example, let us link to Google. Yeah, you type HTTP and do colon double forward slash and you add domain name of google.com. Yeah, let us go to Google. If I save, see, I open it up and it so I'm offline. But if you see here, it is already put the address. So let us see a bit of image. Let's add comment of images. So to add the image in your page, you need to use img tag. So I just type and press enter and to generate this source, which is location of image, and this art will hold the alternative text to show if image is not available. So in my case, I say my image. And then at the source, you can type forward slash and go to image and then forward slash and the name of your image, which is img1.jpg. So if I save, it is shown. So here by default, it will pick the size of image and put it in a browser. So you see it is adding some scroll to the right or left. So because the image is bigger, but if you want to make them small, you can just use attribute of width and you specify it and the height. And with height, you can specify it height. Let's also say 200. And if I save, you see now it is small and fit. So on the image, you can also here specify if it is an outsource. So I don't have connection right now, but I can just show how you can use it. So you can type HTTP forward slash, for example, you can go to an splash, anisplash.com, and you can just go there. You can just go there and pick the image. There are free image. If you are online, you can try to go there and search for the image and copy the link and put it right here in the source attribute. So yeah, you see, if the image is not available, it is displaying this art text at the art. You see, here in my case, it is displaying my image. So let us go on and create a new file. Let's call it list.html. Press exclamation tab. So press Alt Z. So here you can say about list and tables. So here we need to add a heading and say list. Sorry, and tables. Sorry. So yeah, I began with list. So there are two types of list. So let us add it here. Another list. And ordered list. So there are two type list, ANODERED and ORDERED. So if I begin with ANODERED list. So here we use UL tag. So UL tag. Let us add li just for adding an item. If I say item 1, so I can deprecate for times 2, 3, and 4. So if I save, so I need to open this also in the browser. You see, it is displaying. So here we can also have a nested list. So if I add another link, this item, and then add another URL tag, and then I paste the compiled one. I save, you see. So there is also other delete, so I'll copy this one and press Alt Shift Arrow down. So yeah, it is ordered delete, and here I need to change this UL to OL. Let us press Ctrl D to change the next one until all is highlighted. Change to OA and press Escape to return to the current position of cursor. You see, it's changed. So, see, ordered it by default, it ordered by number. So, yeah, we can now go to the tables. Table is created by using table attribute, table tag. And here you can also add table head for head of table. And here you can add td for table data. There you can say name. And add another table data of age, you see, and down here the table head I can add table row, which is row for our table. Yeah, if I also add td name, let us say John. Let us say John, though. Add another td of age. Sorry. And I can say 40. If I save, you see. So I can duplicate and add another row. If I save, you see. Let us say John Smith. And it will adjust to fit the content. So now we can switch to another text here. Let us create a new file of forms.html. So let us press exclamation and tab. So here let us add title of forms. And input. So let's press Alt Z to wrap the content to the width of text editor. So here I can add heading one, say forms, and input, and I can hit save. So here to add the form, and just simply add form attribute and action. You can just put any backend, and you can add method which can be get or post. In our case, just the form. Sorry, it will go nowhere, so I will keep like this. Yeah, I can add div tag. Yeah, so div is just used to group the element or the tag related together. So yeah, I can add the label tag. Yeah, I can say name. So yeah, it's a name. Yeah, of our input. Type text. You can add ID. Name. You can also add placeholder, which is up like a hint, just to guide the user to know the data to be put to here. John Doe. So here I can add, so there is a different input type. So here I can add the tag duplicate and say email. So here you go. If I save, it is shown here. And I can add something called text area. So let us create another div, and there I need to add text area. So this is too much. I can at least leave name. Sorry, an ID. No ID because it's related to ID of message. Because ID is related to label where to go. So here let us add label of message. And message. So if I save, you see it is shown. So here if I add to adjust, I can say calls, and I say like 20. So I think it's already 20. So let us change to 40. And I save, you see. This, it expand, and if I want to adjust, height, I can say, for example, 5. If I save, you see. So here now I can proceed with radio button. So let us add another div. Label. Radio. Label for, I call it. 6. I can add 6. So here I can add input colon radio. So this way of typing input slash radio, I think it works on a Visual Studio. If you are using Notepad, you can just type one by one. So I don't want the name. So yeah, it's a 6. And I can duplicate. So yeah. Let us delete this one. This it is so to add, they are very need to add in the front mail. Maybe. And here I can say female. If I save, this add. So if you want to check one by default, you can add, check the attribute. So here we can go and add our checkbox. Checkbox. So here. We need to change this to let us say spot, and here I can say favorite spot. So, yeah, where it is radio, let us change to checkbox. That's save. So I can add football there, basketball. So I can add many as I can. So here I can add baseball. and netball. So it is checking another one by default. So check as much as you can. But radio, you need to check one at a time. So I can add the value of mal and here value of female. So that one. Here also you can add the value, so when check the entity submitted, it can take that value and save it to the database. So here I can proceed with selection. Does add another div with select attribute. So here I can say also, let us say gender. Select gender or sex. Yeah, we use option tag. So here option one we can say male. We can say male. So let us duplicate down. I can say female. Female. Other. And our unspecified. If I save, you see. So I also can add the default and say selected. So you see it will select the other. So now let us add our submit. So here you can use input with colon submit, which is type submit and value submit, which the value it will display in the browser. So you see. So also we can add the submit button using button attribute. There I can specify type. I can say submit. I can say submit. Or I also can reset. Let us say that this is reset. So here, to reset, for example, if I type John Doe, there email, hello, there I can make different checks, and if I reset, it will just remove everything, and only remain with the default. It's enough, guys. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. So if you wish to see this code, you can just check to my Facebook page on dev. So I will post every single file, and you can copy them there and check yours. So thank you for watching.